When two segments or rays come out of the same point, we form what's called an angle, like angle ABC right here. We measure an angle with what's called degrees. The little symbol there, that little circle, that's the degree symbol. This angle is 145 degrees, and that tells us how open the angle is. If we close the angle, you can see the measure's going down, down, down. If we open up the angle, you can see the measure's going up, up, up. Now, if we close it all the way up, of course, we get 0 degrees. If we open it all the way up, we go all the way around, then that's 360 degrees. Saw it there for just a moment. 360, and then we're back to zero, and around we go again. And the measure tells us what portion of all the way around the angle is. Now, you might be wondering, why do we choose 360 for all the way around? It's kind of a weird number. Why not choose a nice round number like 100? Well, in geometry, we often deal with angles that are a quarter of the way around. That's a quarter of the way around. 360 divided by 4 is an integer. That's 90. This we call a right angle. We deal with this angle so much it has its own special name. We call that a right angle. Now, of course, 100 divided by 4 is also an integer, so that doesn't entirely explain why we use 360. But there are a lot of other angles that pop up a lot in geometry. For example, 1/6 of the way around, that pops up a lot. There's your 60-degree angle. 1/8 of the way around, that pops up a lot as well. That's 45 degrees. Now, all these angles in here are called acute angles. Those are the angles between 0 and 90 degrees. We call those acute angles, and we just saw two that we see a lot. 1/6 of all the way around, divide 360 by 6, you get 60. And 1/8 of the way around, 360 divided by 8, that's 45. So we deal with those two angles a whole lot, and you can't divide 100 by 6 or by 8 and get an integer. Now, out here, between 90 and 180, we have what we call obtuse angles. And one of those we'll see a lot is 1/3 of the way around. That's 120 degrees. So we have angles that are 1/3 of the way around, angles that are 1/6 of the way around, 1/8 of the way around. We deal with those angles a lot. They all come out as integers when we use 360 for all the way around a circle. None of those would come out as integers if we used 100 degrees for all the way around a circle. And we'd like to avoid fractions. So that's one of the reasons we choose 360 for all the way around. Now, I threw a whole lot of names at you while I was going through all that. And I'm figuring, if you're anything like me, you don't listen so well. So I made a slide. This is just for you to remember these names. We'll use these names a lot. You don't have to memorize them right now. We'll use them a lot. You'll remember them. First, we've got the right angle, 90 degree angle right there. We usually mark right angles with a little box like that. This is a right angle. And when we go smaller than a right angle, we form an acute angle. We go larger than a right angle, between 90 and 180, we form what's called an obtuse angle. Let's try a couple problems. First, hey, wait a second. Thought we were doing geometry. This is just a bunch of words. All right, well, we'll turn all these words into math. Now, in geometry, that usually means starting off with a diagram. So we don't just sit there and think about it. We draw a picture first. Go ahead and make a clock. It's not the prettiest clock I've ever seen, but you get the idea. So there's 12, 3, 6, and 9. We'll go ahead and put in the other hours. And we're interested in 4 o'clock. So 4 o'clock, that's right over here. And at 4 o'clock, well, the minute hand is going to point right up here to the 12. And we'll go ahead and put the 12 up there. And the hour hand's going to point right at the 4. Now, 360 degrees is all the way around. That would be all the way around. We want this angle right in here. We don't want the long way around. Usually when we ask for an angle, we always want the short way around. The long way around here, the angle that's more than 180 degrees, we call that a reflex angle. You can forget that name now because we're almost always interested in the short way. We want this angle right here. Now, all the way around is 360 degrees. So how far is just this? We see that there are 12 of these little hours here, 12 of these little segments, these little sections. So if there are 12 sections all the way around, and all the way around is 360 degrees, then each one of these is 360 divided by 12. That's 30 degrees. 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 So this angle here is 4 of these little sections, these little wedges. So this angle here is 4 times 30 degrees, and that is 120 degrees. Now let's try something a little bit trickier. Let's try finding the angle between the hands of a clock at 440. Again, we'll start with our picture, and we'll put our hours in. 12, 3, 6, 9, 1 and 2, 4 and 5, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So there's our 12 up there, and here's our clock. And we're interested in the hands at 440. Well, the minute hand, we know where that's going to be pointing. That's going to be pointing over here at the 8. But what about the hour hand? Now, the hour hand's not going to be pointing right at the 4. I mean, you've seen a clock before. The hour hand moves as well. You know, as the minute hand's moving around, the hour hand is gradually going to be moving from 4 to 5 while the minute hand goes all the way around. So the minute hand's going to be pointing somewhere here between the 4 and the 5. But where will it be pointing? How are we going to figure out this angle? Well, one strategy for figuring out these angles is to break them up. We know this angle. If we broke it up, so we just look at the angle between the 5 and the 8, well, that's 3 of these pieces. We know that each of these pieces is 30 degrees. So this angle here, this is a right angle. This is 90 degrees. But we still have this little sliver out here between the 5 and the hour hand. What's that? Well, in 40 minutes, the minute hand has gone two-thirds of the way around the clock. It's 40 minutes out of 60 minutes, that's two-thirds. So the hour hand must have gone two-thirds of the way from the 4 to the 5. So the hour hand still has one-third of the way to go. The minute hand has one-third of the way to go to finish the clock. The hour hand has one-third of the way to go to finish its path from the 4 to the 5. And we know that going from 4 to the 5 is 30 degrees, so one-third of that, one-third of 30, is 10 degrees. And we put together these two angles to make the angle between the hands of the clock. You get 10 degrees plus 90 degrees. It's 100 degrees. And we're done. Now, before we wrap up, just want to talk a little bit about this program. This little program where we're dragging the point around and seeing the angles change. This dynamic geometry program. It's very cool. You see, there's nothing special about C. I can drag all these things around. This program is called GeoGebra. You can get your copy at GeoGebra.org. It's free and it's awesome.